why I decided to study computer engineering, well, it was actually suggested by my mom. In the beginning, I thought about becoming an industrial engineer because that was broader. But she thought that maybe I could be a good computer engineer. In the meantime, as my career has proceeded, I always had very clear that computer science and computer engineering needed some education along the time. And since my career was going into more the management field, I felt that I needed to study something related to management. And therefore, I started studying a master's degree in business administration. And then I liked it so much that I decided to do a master's degree in social sciences and economics. And then I did my PhD in economics. And then another master's degree in project management. You can focus on computer science or computer engineer, and then if you want to specialize in cloud, you have two choices. Mm-hmm. One is security, because security is very important in cloud, or you can do business or economics, because cloud computing, after all, is business models, so you have to have a lot of math. So, and you have to have a good understanding of the business area. So you can do both, either security or business. But you need to complement somehow the computer engineering skills working in cloud computing. When developing architectures for cloud-based applications, you always have an issue. You always have a problem. There's always something that module doesn't fit with the other module, or doesn't speak to each other, or a variable doesn't work, whatever. So that's one side of the creativity that I like. But then I also like to write research proposals, and then I let my imagination flow too much, and I make up a lot of new concepts and new ideas, and I try to reflect them on paper. To be a good computer scientist, so that's for one thing, that's for sure, but they also need to have other skills and other education. A complementary education in security, network security, cyber security, or in management. Mm-hmm. Also, these executive programs and leadership is very important, especially if you have to lead a team. Conflict resolution, all those soft skills that more and more are demanded nowadays. Technical skills are very important. You need to be proficient in many programming languages, in many different architectures, many different technologies, and in computer science, you can only do that if you study continuously. So if a person wants to go into being a cloud software engineer, they have to have in mind that they will spend the whole time, the whole life studying. All teams that develop software will be more and more multidisciplinary. In the sense that you will have the computer specialist, the computer engineer, and then you will have the psychologist, you have the marketing person, because they all focus on different aspects, and they all help develop the application. So now it's not only the black skin with a black letters that you have. Now you have a lot of designs, user interfaces, and someone has to design it, so you need a graphic designer, but this design has to be in a good way so that a student or a person that uses this application finds it easy. So you need to have some psychology, some sociology, some people that actually work in this user-driven design, and they recommend you how to organize the screen, and then you will have the marketing people that will help you sell your application. You'll have the mathematician that will help you work with the algorithms and with all the big data stuff. So I don't think that now it will be one silo team of computer engineers, but it will be more and more disciplinary. Mm-hmm. And at least that's how I foresee that this work is going to be.